Ah, it's the scent of summer. It never has the onset of the season smelled as good as it does here in this Ilang Ilang flower farm in Iba, Zambales.
In this episode, we're on a different kind of summer holiday for business and leisure, philanthropy and tourism. We're visiting a unique type of farm to see where the prized ingredient found in the world's most iconic scents are harvested and how visitors like us can make a difference.
So join us, I'm David Celdran and this is Executive Class.
I've always been fascinated by the world of perfumery, and with iconic scents like Chanel No. 5 particularly. The legendary French perfume is among the most recognizable and luxurious there is. Its secret? Well, it's more than just about its famous creator and iconic logo. Rather, for its fragrant top notes, the sweet, irresistible scent of Ilang Ilang especially. Because the unique floral notes of the Ilang Ilang combine so well with others, many of the world's top perfumers use it as a key ingredient in their creations. Considered exotic and rare to most outside Southeast Asia, Ilang Ilang is actually a common flower. Most of us grew up with a bush or tree nearby, because, as many botanists say, Ilang Ilang is originally from the Philippines. If so, then why is the oil from the flower used in famous perfumes sourced from elsewhere? Isn't our Ilang Ilang good enough then? The answers to these questions were what got me all curious about this Ilang Ilang farm in Zambales, an old friend of mine told me about. But first, I had to find my way there in the middle of a pandemic.
The farm in Iba, Zambales that we're visiting is about 4 to 5 hours away by road, and it's usually a scenic and pleasant drive. But the pandemic has changed that because now it's much more complicated to get there. You need permits from your LGU, from the Zambales LGU, from the PNP, not to mention all sorts of documents that are required. Apart from that, there are checkpoints along the way that slow down your travel significantly. However, there's an alternative to that. It's a more convenient and stress-free way of traveling there, by chopper.
These days, traveling spontaneously to a remote location like Iba is almost impossible. But chartering a chopper from air taxi gives businessmen, or people like me in a hurry, a valuable option. While filming for the show, I've had to turn to air taxis choppers many times in the past to get to places otherwise too hard to reach or too long to get to by car. But with travel to Zambales still restricted to most, I've never realized how crucial a chopper flight could be till now. The ride above also gives you views of the central Luzon coastline you never get to see if driving inland. The scenery from my seat in the Airbus chopper is spectacular. The fish ponds, farmlands, volcanoes, and rivers that cover central Luzon aren't just lovely to look at. They also remind us of the region's agricultural potential. Yes, despite the many scars left behind by the eruption of Mount Pinatubo in 1991. The flight ends at the Zambales shoreline. Once filled with tourists, it's been empty recently, which made it easier for us to land on the beach.
We just landed in Zambales, which just took under an hour to get here. Although this isn't the farm just yet, this is Botolan, where the landing zone is located. And while we're here, we might as well enjoy the scent of the sea breeze, which has become a rare occasion nowadays, now that travel to the beaches in Luzon have become rather restrictive during the pandemic.
I'd like to stay much longer, but I've got business to attend to. Our farm in Iba is about another 15-minute drive from the beach, and to my surprise, located within the city. Although amidst the vast expanse of ilang-ilang trees, it never feels like you're in the middle of the provincial capital of Zambales.
This is really a lesson in nature. No two trees are alike, and every tree has a story to tell. And this particular tree has a very special story behind it. It was planted by Gina Lopez just months before she passed away. And in a way, all of this is possible because of her. This was Gina Lopez's vision.
Although the ilang-ilang trees were planted recently, the 5,000-hectare property was originally acquired by Gina Lopez and run by the ABS-CBN Foundation to provide livelihood for communities displaced by the Pinatubo eruption. In 2018, the foundation leased the land to Iba Botanicals with a mission of reviving the country's ilang-ilang industry in partnership with the local community.
Ilang-ilang may seem like a common flower in the Philippines especially, but not a lot of people know that it's one of the prized ingredients found in some of the most expensive and iconic perfumes in the world. Now, the irony is, although ilang-ilang is endemic and originally from the Philippines, most of these big perfumers source theirs from other parts of the world. Now, that's what Iba Botanicals hopes to change.
These rows of ilang-ilang trees are just a section of the 8,000 planted by Iba Botanicals since they took over the farm. And though the plantation looks empty at this time of day, an unusual sight unfolds before sunrise every morning. At dawn, hundreds of local women descend on the farm like fireflies to pick flowers from the trees in the dark. Although this looks rather crude, it's actually precision farming. Each flower carefully harvested by hand, and each one picked at the peak of their potency. Not unlike the top wineries of Bordeaux or Burgundy handpick their grapes. Each morning, tons of flowers are collected by the workers and brought to the distillery inside the farm. To ensure quality, all flowers are sorted. Immature and overripe ones are separated from those that are to be steamed. Final step, extracting the essential oil and grading it according to their quality. For every flower picked, only 1% is extracted. So it takes about 18,000 flowers to produce the single vial of essential oil. Because of the uniqueness of the ilang-ilang scent and taste, and the labor-intensive process involved to harvest and extract it, it's sought by the world's top producers of fragrances and flavorings. High employment and a high market value, it's a combination that convinced Iba Botanicals to focus on ilang-ilang farming.
Hey, Ben.
Hey, David.
Recognize you from the photographs.
Welcome.
It's a wonderful place, yeah. So this is where it all happens.
It is. This is where the magic happens.
Ben Mead, the company's founder and CEO's mission is twofold, and both are daunting. One, to export superior quality ilang-ilang oil, a task which requires precision farming. The other, to provide long-term and quality employment to generations of locals and displaced Itas who now live here.
And why ilang-ilang in particular?
So ilang-ilang is native to the Philippines.
A lot of people don't know that.
Yeah, it is.
Strangely, right?
Yeah.
I've always known from since I was a kid that ilang-ilang grew in the Philippines, but I didn't realize this was the way it originated.
That's right. But unfortunately, most of the commercial production as it relates to ilang has been conducted offshore in Madagascar, Comoros, and a few other places.
So how did it get there?
Essentially, foreigners traveling through the Philippines with an understanding of the industry, identifying this as a very strong flavor and fragrance ingredient, taking the seeds offshore and establishing the commercial plantations. Mm-hmm. So we have established the first commercial plantation of ilang-ilang in the Philippines, mm-hmm. at least today, and we've recently commenced production. Our plantations here in Iba Zambales will grow to a very significant production, so we'll represent a significant percentage of overall global production. But most importantly, we're getting recognition globally that the quality of the oil coming from our trees in the Philippines is better than anywhere else.
Clearly, this is much more than just about business, nor just about philanthropy. If Iba Botanical succeeds, they also help reclaim the Philippines' position as one of the world's first and leading producers of ilang-ilang oil, a once-flourishing trade up until the early 20th century. Which is probably why the uniquely Filipino name, ilang-ilang, is used as a common term for the Kananga odorata plant variety.
Is Philippine ilang-ilang different from the ilang-ilang that is far more popular now, although not from the, although it was taken to islands like Madagascar? What's the difference?
So it does come from the same species. Mm. So the seeds that are planted offshore were sourced in the Philippines, but as is the case with a lot of natural products, the output is different, which is a function of the climate and the soil and the practices and things like that. Thankfully, the feedback that we have is that the ilang ilang oil that we're producing here in Iba Zambales is the best in the world.
And really?
It's being called the truest representation of the ilang flower.
And that's a great way of putting it.
Absolutely.
That's the best way to sell our own ilang ilang.
And that's really what differentiates our ilang ilang Filipina is on that quality, but also on our practices, our sustainability, transparency, and inclusive practices. So we think the future for ilang ilang from the Philippines as a flavor and fragrance ingredient is very, very exciting.
The future of Ilang Ilang Filipina does indeed seem sweet. Here in the distillery, Ben's team is busy preparing samples for clients around the world.
It's interesting, Ben was just telling me, Ilang Ilang comes in different grades of quality. Extra, that's premium, and 1, 2, 3, depending on the market and the application.
That's right.
The final product that it's gonna be found in.
That's right.
Okay, so like perfume at the top, and at the bottom, maybe like soaps?
Soaps, shampoos, cleaning products.
Yeah. Amazing.
Yeah.
The possibilities offered by this versatile plant seem endless. Even flowers that were rejected can be dried to make tea leaves or applied in medicine and therapy. But most exciting is when, finally, after a century of disappearing from the global scene, our native ilang-ilang will find its way to the world's top perfumes.